Hello and welcome to the No Name Prayer Podcast. I am your host, Monica. Thank you for joining me today. We're going to read from the book, There's Power in Your Tongue by Maria Vadia. Moored on the Word. Psalm 119, verse 103. How sweet are thy words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. I cannot say enough about the Word of God. Without it, we cannot grow spiritually. God has been more than gracious in giving us His Word, which reveals His will. Now that we have been transferred from the dominion of darkness to God's kingdom, Colossians 1 verse 13, we need to learn the ways of this new kingdom. And this includes talking and speaking and acting like King Jesus. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16 says that all scripture is inspired by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, that the men of God may be complete, equipped for every good work. In order to become mature and be able to serve our God effectively, in order to be transformed into the image of Christ, in order to evangelize, which is the mission of the church, we need the Word of God. It simply cannot be done apart from the Word, for it is God's Word that brings life and truth. Salvation does not take place apart from the gospel, for it is the power of God for salvation to everyone who has faith. Romans 1 verse 16. People need to hear the word of truth, the good news of the gospel, in order to repent of their sins and turn to Jesus. Someone has to tell them. Why is it this way? Because it pleased God through the folly of what we preach to save those who believe. 1 Corinthians 1 verse 21b. It is our responsibility to share the gospel with all. This is God's will, because He desires all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4. You and I are supposed to share this truth with all, because the Lord does not want that even one person perish. Sharing and preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ, the message of salvation, is really proclaiming words that bring life. In Mark 16, verse 15, Jesus told His followers to preach the gospel to the whole creation. Little people like you and I have been given this incredible privilege and responsibility of being able to bring people into God's kingdom through the sharing of the gospel message. This is really using our tongue for life. The Word of God is so powerful that I would like to share some of the ways in which it helps us to grow in holiness and become more Christ-like. God's words are spirit and life. John 6, verse 63. It is the spirit that gives life. The flesh is of no avail. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. They are like a seed. Mark 4. There will be good fruit coming from the seed of the word. They are like a lamp and light. Psalm 119 verse 105. They bring needed revelation, because light is more powerful than darkness. The darkness has to flee when the light comes in. They are like a hammer and a fire. Jeremiah 23 verse 29. They tear down strongholds and every proud thing that exalts itself against the lordship of Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians 10 verses 4 and 5. Fire purifies. They will never pass away. Matthew 24 verse 35. You can stand on this. They are sweet as honey. Ezekiel 3 verse 3. They have no power to transform us. They have the power to transform us and drive out the garbage out of our system and bring sweetness into our lives. They keep us from sin. Psalm 119 verse 11. They tell us what pleases and displeases the Lord. They strengthen us. Psalm 119 verse 28. They are power packed. They revive us. Psalm 119 verse 25. They have resurrection power. They make us wise. Psalm 119 verse 98. They reveal to us the wisdom of God, not the wisdom of the word, the world. They give us understanding. Psalm 119 verse 99. We understand now from God's perspective, the eternal perspective. They give us peace. Psalm 119, 165. Because we know He is in control. They counsel us. Psalm 119, verse 24. They give us the only advice that counts. They comfort us. Psalm 119, verse 50. You don't need pills, drugs, or alcohol. The word will meet you at the point of your need. They are like water that washes us. Ephesians 5 verse 26. We need to be cleansed daily. They are like a mirror. James 1 verse 23. They know us where we fall short so that we desire to change. They uphold and sustain us. Hebrews 1 verse 3. The biggest force in the universe. They are like rock. Matthew 7 verse 25, the only solid foundation. They become the sword of the Spirit, Ephesians 6 verse 17. With it we defeat the enemy and every evil attack. They are life and healing to all our flesh, Proverbs 4 verse 22. Take them just like medicine and you will see results. It is up to us to feed on God's word and be transformed so that we can become a people that bring life and blessings to others. Tell me, what is more fruitful from the eternal perspective? To get into the word and pray the word, or watch one more TV show? Definitely to pray the word. And get into the word. You know, I have a confession to make to you guys. I did not feel like praying today. But I rebuke that in the name of Jesus. And I choose God, I choose His word, I choose His love and His forgiveness over anything that the enemy wants to put in my head, wants to make me feel, wants to make me believe, because He's a liar. And God is good. I pray that you have peace and that you feel his embrace, that you feel God's arms around you, that He hugs you tight, that He fills all that emptiness and the voids within you, that He gives you strength and courage to keep on going, to go through whatever you're going through. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for listening. Please share with a friend. Don't forget to follow. Pray for me, that I will pray for you.